Matthew's so specific in this text. Jesus is walking around towns and regions that are difficult to pronounce. Why do we care about Naphtali and blah, 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 blah? Matthew is so specific because he's locating Jesus in the history of his people. This one, for Matthew, is the one he's been waiting for, the one to fulfill prophecy in the Hebrew scriptures, the one called by God, set apart by God to do this radically revolutionary thing called movement building, called making love everywhere. My friend, Dominic Crisson, says that Jesus doesn't become Jesus, not the resurrected Jesus, not the Son of God Jesus. My friend Marcus Borg says Jesus doesn't become the resurrected Jesus, the Son of God Jesus. Both of these theologians don't think of Jesus, Yeshua of Nazareth, as anything besides a human rabbi until after the resurrection. These are two Christian theologians, and that might surprise us. But for them, something momentous, something tremendous, something life-altering, something other than we can really imagine happens when Jesus dies and comes back to life. In the meantime, in this time, in this moment, in the narrative, Jesus is a dark-skinned Palestinian Jewish rabbi from a poor town called Nazareth, and he's on the move through towns whose names we can't pronounce. He's on the move, Matthew wants us to know, because Isaiah places the Messiah on the move in those places. He's on the move, Matthew wants us to know, because Jesus is the start of a movement. He's on the move looking for people, looking for a posse, looking for some folks to join him on the march for the long road to freedom. He's moving about. He's gathering here and there. He's picking people in their ordinariness to join the movement, stopping here at the Sea of Galilee to get some fishermen to tell them that they will no longer fish for fish, but they will gather other people into the movement. He's on the move, Jesus is, gathering regular folks, ordinary folks, unlearned folks, not such special folks, but folks who will pick up on the urgency of the call to resist. Make no mistake about it, this is a feisty, rabble-rousing, trouble-causing rabbi calling people to follow in the way of resistance, resisting empire, because that is the context. This is occupation, and I don't mean Wall Street, or maybe I do. This is Rome pushing against boundaries, gobbling up everything in its sight, taking over territories, demanding high taxes of the people that were already poor. This is Rome forcing them into labor without pay, without rights, without health care, without organizing, Tom. This is Rome flexing her muscles. Let's make it a hymn. Rome flexing his muscles. Without regard to religion, without regard to station, you will worship this God called Caesar. You will pay homage to this God with your life and your livelihood. And into this is born the little Palestinian poor baby, right, sleeping in the cow trough, growing up to learn his father's craft, gnarly hand carpenter man, moving about the countryside, healing, preaching, teaching, and then calling people into the way, into the resistance movement. What did you need to get in the movement? Just ears that were willing to hear. Just ears that were willing to hear the call and feet that were willing to get up and go. Ragamuffin band of unqualified disciples, 12 of them, one of them a traitor. 11 and a half disciples. And some women, like Mary, and the other Mary, and the other Mary, the wife of Cleophas Mary, and Miriam, and all of those women, too unimportant to be listed in the Bible, nonetheless, following around the way, making a space for Jesus to lay his head, fixing him some victuals on the side when he was hungry. All of those men and women joining in the movements, 12 and a half, 11 and a half disciples, and some women, and the 140 up in the upper room, making a worldwide movement that we've come to call Christianity. But a movement that Jesus launched just to reform, just to fix, just to break the frame. You have heard it say, don't kill, I say, don't even go to bed angry. You have heard it said, don't commit adultery, I say, don't even lust. Raising the bar on spirituality, but lowering the bar on who can be called a child of God. Make no mistake about it. Jesus was calling those people into a movement of resisting empire. The qualifications, be willing to hear, but the task, difficult. High risk, put down your nets, put down your livelihood, hell, you might even have to put down your life to follow me along the way. You might have to let go of the stuff your family told you was important. Like, we don't like gays, or we don't like blacks, or we must raise walls against the immigrants when they come to take back the land we took from them. You might have to let go of your schooling and the messages you heard when you were young and the things you held dear and precious, like money makes might and right. Like the firstborn and the first who take the land and the first who build the empire get to keep it. You might have to surrender your own fears of failure. You just might have to own your beauty and your power and your strength and your giftedness and your vulnerability, because those are the kinds of skills needed along the way as we resist. Matthew is so specific. Towns we can't pronounce. Describing the beginning of the movement that continues today. Oh, you should have seen it. A sea of people, like a wall, or an amoeba, I don't know, pulsating, moving. So many people on the subway car, there was no way to fall down. So many people holding you when you rocked. Polite, gentle, no shoving, no pushing. Peacemaking, waymaking, kind people. Making way for children. Making way for the infirm. One woman had a cow because she was so crowded with people. And she kind of got on her knees and had her dog and was like, I just need some space. I just need some space. And what did the people do? They gave her space. People shared water and snacks and attaboys and girls took pictures of signs, some pretty funny, some pretty obscene, yet funny still. Some pretty anatomically correct. With the don't grab this, you know. I didn't make the sign, I'm just reporting. I'm the reporter. You should have seen the sea of pink hats. You should have seen the men in the pink hats. You should have seen the children holding up signs, inviting us to love them, because love is love is love. 200 cities. Millions of people have heard the call. And it is a call to a movement. And they might not believe in the God we love. They might not believe in the Christ we follow in the mission and ministry, but they believe in the justice, and they believe in the vision of God's whole and healed world, and they believe in the rights of women to be women, and they believe in the rights of the poor to have what they need. And this vision, this sense of shared vision of the world that we can create together, has called us out and has called us in to the river. Okay, maybe it's not a river. Maybe it's a road. And maybe it's a road with many access points. And maybe the road is long and hard. But maybe if we're walking there together and we're holding each other's hands and we've got good shoes, we can keep on moving until we get to the city called freedom, until we get to the land called justice. You know, words we can pronounce, places we can actually say out loud that we mean. Something like Jubilee, where debts are forgiven and people are whole. A place called love, where love is love is love is love, and we stop worrying about who's sleeping with who. There's a movement. There's a movement afoot, and the movement trumps hatred. The movement trumps oppression. Perhaps even we might have to admit that if it didn't get to be this funky, is that a theological, can I say funky? If it didn't get to be this cray-cray, if it didn't get to be quite this depressing, if it didn't get to be quite this shadowy and ominous and frightening, just maybe we wouldn't have risen up. Yeah. But it was, and we have risen up. My friend Matthew Ray Michaels is calling this the inauguration. Oh, I gotta just stand a little higher, but I wanna be near you. Don't look, you know, be careful, okay. Listen to the poem by my friend, prophet, resistor, Michael Ray Matthews, called Inauguration. And so it began, again. The chaos, the void, the formlessness. We felt the night falling, kith and kin threatened by the darkness, bottles and epithets lobbed from passing cars, court police pursuing the peaceful prophets. But Jubilee got it right. This darkness is not of the tomb, but of the womb. Hovering over the uncertainty is a presence, a voice, calling in the light. The people sitting in darkness will see a great light. And for those who sit in the region and shadow of death, light is already dawning. Las Morenas, clothed with the sun, prepare to march in the light, crying out lest hope unborn dies. Houses of faith, shod with moral courage, rehearse songs of resistance, prayers of hope, forging acts of revolutionary love. Kindred, we are light. Now is the time to shine with abandon. Now is the time to inaugurate the light in others. In the light, we can defend and protect the vulnerable. In the light, we can nurture beloved community. In the light, we can cultivate prophetic resistance. In the light, we can be fearless in our hope, daring in our vision. Yes, oh yes, it begins again in love, in hope, in faith, in the light. In the resistance.
Our souls are brought together so that we can love each other, brother. We are here. We are here.
Don't let anyone tell you that being a Christian is a namby-pamby project. Don't let anyone fool you into thinking that God wants us to participate in empire. Don't let anyone tell you something about rendering under Caesar what belongs to Caesar. The only thing that belongs to Caesar is domination. And what belongs to the people of God is freedom. What belongs to the people of God is freedom. What belongs to the people of God is freedom. What belongs to the people of God is freedom. What belongs to the people of God is freedom. What belongs to the people of God is freedom. What belongs to the people of God is freedom. 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 Resistance is an act of faith. Amen.